reason minimalist running shoes, which are barefoot-like shoes that have a very thin sole, or even running barefoot, one reason these running conditions have been producing a data trend in the research for doing a better job at encouraging more optimal mechanical arrangements that are good for impact protection and better landing stability, because there's simply less mechanical interference between the foot and the ground that the foot has to wrestle with as compared with running in shoes that have a thick and very soft, squishy cushioned outsole. In fact, running in really thick, soft, cushioned running shoes may almost surely cause landings to be harder on the ground and may cause irregular movement patterns of the foot, like overpronation, which means the back of the foot shifts into straining extreme positions during the touchdown and stance phases of running. Proving true of this is a 2015 study in the journal Footwear Science, which is linked down below this video in the description box, found that the thicker and softer the underfoot materials of a shoe when running, the more the foot was forced to pronate or shift around, the greater the maximum vertical loading rates, which means the greater the downward force of the foot with the ground, the higher the force time integral, which means there was more loading that lasted longer on the foot and leg. But last but not least, the longer the ground contact time duration, which means the foot spent more time on the ground. All of these metrics are well known to increase the risk of injury, because higher than normal levels of vertical loading that persist longer in duration could result in excessive impact that the muscles can't absorb. As for increased ground contact time of the foot, it's been linked to injury, because the longer the foot spends interacting on the ground when running, the more time that there may be for the foot to shift into extreme overstraining positions, which is partly why there was excessively forced pronation of the foot in the runners who ran in thick, soft cushion running shoes. To account for why soft, thick underfoot cushioning produced these negative injurious interactions during running, the researchers concluded that it wasn't so much the thicker the underfoot cushioning that was all that problematic. Rather, it was the softer the cushioning that resulted in a prolonged compression duration of the soft cushioning from the foot during the stance phase of running. In other words, the foot spent an unusual prolonged time pushing through all the soft compressible material to reach the ground during the stance phase of running. What's worse is that the runners were unaware that they were actually striking harder on the ground. And this is something that's called perceptual illusions, which is a term that was coined by Dr. Stephen Robbins, who's done a lot of pioneering work on barefoot versus shod or shoe running, and how some running shoes can actually be a mechanical interference that may push foot strike and leg swing mechanics outside a greater distance, outside its natural ranges, and may cause you to land too hard on the ground without even knowing it. His paper on that is entitled Athletic Footwear Unsafe Due to Perceptual Illusions, which is also linked down below this video in the description box. Getting back to the study in softer cushion running shoes was compared to running in firmer cushion running shoes, which was associated with less rapid overpronation and more controlled landing stability. These metrics are consistent with other studies that have investigated the impact and mechanical metrics in barefoot runners and minimalist runners, of which most of these studies have found the same basic conclusion, in that barefoot and minimalist runners consistently showed more controlled pronation, stronger footstep stability, and landed with much less collisional impact and much less downward force, as compared with runners in thickly cushioned conventional running shoes, of which these runners consistently produced more all-around force components acting across the foot and the leg, which may also result in greater muscle response to counteract excessive pronation and impact production. In keeping with this, one false assumption is that the thicker and softer a running shoe is, the more impact will be absorbed. But in reality, several studies over the past few decades have found that soft, thick cushion running shoes are one of the biggest stressors or risk factors that cause excessive pronation and excessive impact production that the cushioning of the shoe can't absorb, and the muscles and the tendons of the leg can't absorb either, and is one of the countless reasons an overwhelming majority of runners continue to get hurt. That said, if you want to break the flow of high impact and achieve sturdier landing stability in a sustainable way, it's best to try minimalist running shoes, or even better, running barefoot, because these running conditions actually improves the neuromuscular and reflexive movement coordination through the increases in ground feel, whereas the thicker and softer the underfoot cushioning when running, the more impact intensive, the more mechanically reckless, and therefore the more injury prone you may be. That said, if you prefer to run in shoes with cushioning, aim for a cushioned shoe that feels more firm, just like how the ground feels when you run barefoot or in minimalist shoes. The ground feels more firm, not pillowy, and it's that firmness is what delivers more natural-like stimulus for enhanced neuromuscular and reflexive responses in landing control and leg swing mechanics that may help reduce harmful impact loads. This could be one of the reasons that the Nike Vaporfly, or the Cheater Fly as many call it, hasn't really caused a lot of injuries as was expected, given how ridiculously thickly cushioned these shoes are. However, the underfoot sensation of these shoes is very firm, not pillowy or plush in the least, and it's this firmness and feel that could be partly of what's stopping these runners in these shoes from getting hurt. So essentially, the take-home message is that thick underfoot cushioning that is overly soft and very compressible may be counterproductive because the consistent consequences of higher than normal impact levels and abnormal pronation that these shoes seem to bring about as compared with firmer cushioned running shoes, minimalist running shoes, or running barefoot, underfoot substrates that have a firmness feel at the underfoot are more consistently on record for producing results that seem to make running more safe. Hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to hit the thumbs up button as well as the subscribe button if you haven't already. We will stay more informed on heel strike running versus forefoot strike running, as well as more informed on the benefits of barefoot and minimalist running. Thank you so much for listening and watching. Have fun out there on the roads and trails. Bye for now.